Hi there, Tamara Doris here, and I am doing my first video in my new office. I wish you could see the whole thing, and maybe I'll have to do some kind of a little video and show you, because it's just like so awesome to go from dark green walls for 15 years or however long it's been to these bright white walls. Want to see my art? Can you see in the back with the heart? That's made out of feathers. Don't judge. Speaking of, that's what our topic is today, judging. Judging is something that we're all guilty of, we all do, but the honest to goodness truth is, unless we're a judge, you know, with a gavel, then we shouldn't judge. If we're a judge with a gavel, then we should judge because, well, that's how we get paid. But notwithstanding, you like that legal term? Notwithstanding being a judge with a gavel, we shouldn't judge. And here's why. You know, if you kind of go with the whole premise that we're all one, then when we judge someone else, we're actually judging ourselves. And judging, it's an addiction. It's a toxic addiction. We can't help ourselves. And the reason I think, on a psychological level, the reason we judge is because we're comparing ourselves. It's inherent that we compare ourselves with others. You know, oh, she's got a better yoga pose, or oh, he makes more money, or whatever it might be. We can't compare ourselves to other people. But that's a whole other video. The point that I'm trying to make about judging is that when we judge someone, we're sending arrows like a boomerang that come right back to us. Because when we judge someone else, then we're actually judging ourselves. So that's something to think about. When we judge someone else, we're actually judging ourselves. And we're sending all those poison arrows right back to us. No bueno. The other thing to remember that's kind of empowering with this whole concept is when we compliment or think nice thoughts about someone else, that's going to come right back to us as well. So instead of judging someone when we don't know, we have no idea what it's like to be them or who they are, we may think we do, but unless we are actually that person, we can't really judge them, right? So when we think good thoughts, and you know, speak complimentary and things of that nature, then those things are going to come right back to us. So here's what you do. Next time you're in a conversation and you kind of catch yourself judging someone, especially if you're talking, which is called gossiping, just catch yourself and say, but you know what? She's got so many great attributes. Or say you judge someone because they're, I don't know, condescending or stuck up or whatever. Say, but you know what? He's really a nice guy. You catch yourself and then you kind of like erase that karma. Good deal? And likewise, go ahead and just give compliments and think complimentary thoughts. Go ahead and give that good energy out there because it's going to come back to you, right? So that is the message for today. Do not judge unless you're a judge. And then judge what you have to judge. Fair enough? If you want to go to my blog, it's www.tamaradoris.com, and I hope you have a fabulous day. Bye-bye for now.